Seneca Avenue has been a destination for Halloween night for decades. Starting in the mid-80s, residents on this street started decking out their houses. No coordination, just lots of great Halloween spirit. This year, like last year, they're hoping to keep it just to their own neighbors because of the pandemic.
This year, we're acknowledging that we're still in COVID times, although we have lots of enthusiasm for next year to come back and enjoy Seneca. But this year, we're going to be taking it a lot easier, keeping those public health protocols in mind. We can't stop anyone from trick-or-treating, but we do want to avoid some disappointment, and we know a lot of the houses here this year are looking to be a lot quieter and to not invite those trick-or-treaters from in town and around. We did do some engagement to ask people what their comfort levels were. If they were intending to do the full thing this year, we would help to keep some protocols available to them. If they were looking to generally quiet down again this year, exactly the same as last year, then they would be doing that. So we're really looking for folks to respect our residents, and just as how we've addressed a lot to do with the pandemic, we've been focusing in on respect and kindness and looking forward to brighter days.
After significant social media backlash after a post was made about the road closure, Mayor Marianne Mead Ward made this statement.
We're really encouraging everybody, not just on Seneca, but everybody, please stay in your own neighborhood. And we've closed the streets before on Seneca, really for pedestrian safety, because we can never predict how many people are coming to the street. There's been crowds as many as 5,000 people. We're trying to discourage that, but the road will be closed to allow to vehicle traffic, to just in case if there are significant numbers of pedestrians. Staff are also closing the adjacent parking lots attached to the library, because what used to happen is people would drive from far afield, they'd park in some of those lots and come down the street. So again, to discourage crowding, those parking lots will be closed off. But the street is being closed to manage crowds. And it has been pretty well every year for a number of years. But it doesn't mean that people won't be handing out candy. So some will on Seneca, some won't. But really, the residents have said, please don't come in the numbers that you were before. We're not ready and set up, and COVID is still with us. And I know people are making comparisons too, but we can go to sports venues and all that. You know, you have to be vaccinated to do that. There's social distancing that is put into place. This is a street party.
So this year, show your own neighborhood a little love. And we'll show a little gratitude to the folks on Seneca who spend $600 and $700 every year on candy for the thousands of trick-or-treaters who regularly come here. Reporting for Halton News, I'm Nikki Wesley. Happy Halloween.